long time ago, there was a fishing village. Hardly even a village, just a few huts nestled in the crook between two cliffs on the edge of the sea. A woman lived there with her husband. The husband had a rumor that she'd been unfaithful. He didn't wait to find out the truth. He carried her up to the top of one of the cliffs, put stones in her pockets, and threw her over. She landed in the water and sank down and down, down into the darkness, deeper and deeper until she settled on the sand at the bottom. The fish came out from behind their rocks and shells and looked at her. She was beautiful, with flowing hair like seaweed, bright anemone eyes and coral lips. She looked delicious. It doesn't hurt to be eaten by fish. It's like a series of little kisses. They kissed and kissed her until the flowing hair was gone, the bright eyes were gone, the coral lips were gone, and there was nothing left but bone. Thank you. nobody from that village could ever catch any fish in those waters. They would throw in their nets and their lines and haul them in empty. Gradually, word spread that the sea there was haunted. Nobody fished there anymore. The villagers moved away, and the cove became deserted. One evening, many years later, a young man rowed his fishing boat around to where the village had been. He was short and muscular, with long dark braids and eyes black as the stones on the beach. He'd heard the stories about the haunted water, but he didn't believe in ghosts. Or he thought he didn't believe in ghosts, which is not quite the same thing. He made a camp in one of the abandoned huts near the shore, had a simple supper and a good night's sleep. Then the next day at dawn, he took his boat out to fish. In the pink morning light, he threw in his nets and his lines and caught nothing. He could see the fish swimming around, the sea was full of them, but somehow they managed to avoid him. He persisted as the sun rose slowly overhead, burning the back of his neck, and carried on as it started to sink down again. The reflection from the water dazzling his eyes. He refused to give up. He refused to give up. He refused to give up.
Thank you.
pulled it in, hand over hand. It was big and heavy. He imagined the feast he would have that night. At last, he pulled it up to the surface. Instead of a fish, he saw a white bone face. His hook was caught in the eye of the skeleton woman, and he could swear that she was laughing. The fisherman screamed. He dropped the line and started rowing away as fast as he could. But the line was attached to the boat, and the skeleton woman was attached to the line, so she just followed him. He rowed back and forth through the waves, trying to get rid of her, but the further he rowed, the more tangled up she got with his fishing line. Eventually, he reached the shore, and he jumped out of the boat and dragged it up onto the beach. But just as he turned to run back to his hut, he saw her. Just a pile of bones all tied up in his fishing line in a heap on the edge of the water. Suddenly, he felt sad for the skeleton woman. He wondered how she'd come to drown. He felt silly for having been so afraid. He picked up the tangle of bones and fishing line and carried them in his arms back to the hut. For hours, he sat there as the sky darkened, carefully unraveling the bones from the wire and rearranging them back in order, until the skeleton woman lay on the floor of his hut, rearranged and perfect. And he pulled a blanket over her, got into his bed and fell asleep. Thank you. The skeleton woman sat up.
The skeleton woman sat up.
The skeleton woman sat up. She went over to the sleeping man and reached into his chest.
The skeleton woman sat up. She went over to the sleeping man and reached into his chest. She went over to the sleeping man and reached into his chest. She went over to the sleeping man and reached into his chest.
She took his heart in her hand and looked at it. Flesh, she said. Flesh, 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 in time with the beating of his heart.
Flesh, 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 flesh.
As she spoke, the flesh grew back onto her bones. She regained the body of a living woman. The lips, the eyes, the hair. In his sleep, his heart held in the drowned woman's hand, the fisherman dreamed. He dreamed of childhood. Of his mother holding him in her arms. Of his grandmother teaching him the songs of his village. Of playing with his sister. The dreams were joyful. But his grandmother was dead now. His sister married and left long ago. His mother still living nearby, but somehow he forgot to ever visit her. And in his sleep, he started to cry. The skeleton woman, who wasn't a skeleton anymore, leaned over him and drank his tears. She felt herself grow strong. Carefully, she put the fisherman's heart back into his chest. And she smiled at him as he opened his eyes and looked up at her beautiful face. And he smiled back. Thank you. They lived together from then on in the village between the two cliffs. And they were always able to catch abundant fish from the waters that weren't haunted anymore.